Hi guys, welcome to Commercial Law Tutorials. Under the topic Introduction to Law, in our first lesson we looked at the definition and characteristics of law. Today we are moving on to lesson number 2. In this lesson we will look at the purposes of law. In this lesson we will focus on the purposes of law, which are also the importance of law. And at the end of the lesson, we shall highlight some common exam questions relating to this topic. Now, I would like to list the purposes of law, which we will discuss today in this lesson, before explaining them in detail. Law serves the purposes of establishing standards, promoting social justice, settling disputes, preserving or maintaining order, maintaining status quo, and lastly, facilitating orderly change. Now, let us look at these purposes of law in detail. First and foremost, we will look at the purpose of law, which is to establish standards. We realize that law tells the threshold between acceptable and unacceptable behaviors in our society. What we must and what we may do is outlined in law, as well as all that is prohibited or forbidden. Thus, legal and illegal actions are clearly set by law. People in the state behave in an accepted and standard way, which protect the interest of everyone. For example, causing physical injury to others is assault, except in self-defense. Therefore, law helps to shape moral standards in the society. Let us now move on to our second purpose of law, which is to preserve or maintain order. Imagine if everyone was allowed to do as they wish, what they want, not considering other people who are around or our environment. It would be hectic, I tell you. There would be no peace in our communities. So as law provides standards, it is there to guide people what they should do, what they may do, and what they must not do, thereby governing the human behavior and actions of people in the state at any given time. By controlling the human behavior, law ensures the reduction in the areas of conflict among citizens, be it at home, workplace, or just around the community or neighborhood you live, thus giving each person boundaries so that no one's actions are supposed to affect, punish, or enslave another person's, then by maintaining peace and order in the state. Thirdly, law has got the purpose of promoting social justice in our community. The constitution of a state provides for all manner of liberties and rights. These human rights are the basic rights and freedoms that belong to every person from birth until death. The rights apply equally on everyone, regardless of place of residence, gender, race, religion, language, or any other status. Some examples are the freedom of religious belief, prohibition of slavery and torture, right to fair trial, and right to equality before the law. So one function of the law is to protect these rights and liberties from violation by other people, organizations, or government. Additionally, law regulates and keeps equality between disadvantaged and advantaged ones in the society. For instance, in taxation law, people who earn more pay more tax than people who earn less. Companies are also divided into tax brackets depending on the tax revenue of the corporations. Imagine everyone paying same amount of tax, the poor paying the same as the rich. This would mean the poor would just live and work for the tax without money for food and other basic needs. Some would always be in arrears as they try to balance tax and their basic needs. That won't be fair, right? So law promotes social justice. Let us move on to the fourth purpose of law. Law helps to settle disputes in our community. Disputes are unavoidable, as people in the society have different needs, wants, and values, as well as views. At some given time, people will conflict. The law therefore provides a formal means to solve the disputes using courts. The law gives the guidelines for solving the disputes which arise among the people in the state. For example, the contract law. Contract law regulates the disputes between people who have signed any document. Next, law maintains status quo in the society. Status quo refers to the existing state of affairs or circumstances. This means that the position remains the same, circumstances remains the same, everything is normal in our community, such that things do not change rapidly and everything can be predictable. Law therefore maintains that state in our community. Thus, order and peace is maintained and the state becomes a reliable place to be. Law helps the society environment to therefore remain stable. For example, laws preventing the forcible overthrow of government. Imagine if anyone could remove and overthrow the government at any given time. No formal government would exist, as governments would be overthrown frequently. New ones would come and the cycle would repeat itself. Thus, even productivity in our nations would be hard to witness. Law is therefore important in our society as it maintains the state of things in the society. The last point we are going to look at today is that law facilitates orderly change. Laws ensure that there is always logical change of things in the society. Laws assist in enabling an orderly change in the society. People follow certain rules which ensure that a flawless and non-violent change is promoted in the society. This is so because law highlights what should be done and followed through in the process of change, hence an orderly change is realized. For instance, laws promoting that proposed statutes go through public scrutiny. This ensures that all laws are for the best interest of all the people in the society. Laws will not benefit just a few who change those laws for their own benefit. The public can therefore look at the proposed laws, accept or reject those laws. Therefore, laws will benefit everyone in the society. Another good example we can give in this case is the electoral process laws, which restrict rigging of votes, promote transparency and shun violence during elections in various countries. That was it, guys. Let's now move on to the last section of our lesson. In this section, we are going to look at the exam questions that are commonly asked. And today I've got lots of questions for you. Discuss the primary functions of law. What are the roles played by the law in the society? Discuss the functions of law in the business. Discuss the importance of law in our society. How do the society benefit from law? Briefly write on any six main purposes of law. What purposes do law serve in our society? Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, comment, and like.